Hey Sean Jantz here. I'm doing a quick backup plan for Wednesday, July 29th. I'm going to do it on slash ES, which is the S&P 500 and the other indices that you can find on NADEX. And I'm going to start here on slash ES. And every single evening, I always like to start here on the 4-hour chart, as you can see right there. And as far as a day trader goes, the 4-hour chart is the most important chart to understand. Is what is our bias on this 4-hour chart? Are we overbought, oversold, or are we at equilibrium? I'm going to speed this trade plan up, and I did a live trade plan the previous evening, and we pretty much have roughly the same structure. There's not much new to talk about. We are sitting absolutely my favorite, by far, best type of structure, best type of bias to be in. When you look at the 4-hour chart, we are starting to come into a little bit of demand here. But when you move to the eagle view, this market has a lot of room to continue dumping. So just be aware of that. Okay. So I do think that we are going to see some significant dumps in this market. I don't know when it's coming, but I know that it is. I want to make sure that you are fully aware of that. The risk is definitely to the downside. And then, of course, we're going to have some really nice structure if the market decides to come up into these pockets. So when we move here, 15-day, 15-minute plot chart, and like I said, I'm going to make this quick, so I'm going to go through this. We have really nice, clean, valuery high, BTG plus 0.5, get up into there and find change control. Could be an opportunity for 80% roll if you can catch it. I'm probably going to hold off on it, but there is some decent... There is a decent size valuary box. And then obviously we have all of this beautiful supply, Thursday's POC, Friday's POC, plus one, and all of that structure. To the downside, pretty clean. You got the negative 0.5. It's not perfect. It's pretty much right in the middle of this 15-day range. But if you want to look for some quick change control, my favorite demand pocket would be pulling back into this negative one or into that negative 1.5. You move here to slash in cube, really nice clean lines. You can see potential 80% roll if you can catch it. Plus 0.5 is not terrible, but same concept as ES. It's literally right smack dab in the middle. So if you are going to look for a sell trigger there, make it quick. I do like the plus 1 and the plus 1.5. To the downside, it's pretty clean. You got negative 0.5, negative 1. I likely won't be trading down there if it breaks that support. Same thing to the upside on YM, possible 80% roll. This would be my favorite chart for 80% roll, just because it has an insane amount of volume right there. And how do I know that? Because of the POC clusters. There's so much volume right there that if these bulls get back inside and start holding pullbacks, there's your opportunity, there's your entry, mental stop, and lock and trail right into those POCs. That's why it's so cool to have these BTG charts. Here's your really nice supply level, as long as there's good change control. To the downside, negative 0.5 isn't perfect, but there is going to be some pockets of demand around negative 1 and negative 1.5. RTY actually has clean lines as well for 80% roll. You can see how it has that bunch of POC clusters. I do really like this for first resistance, and then there's second. You got the negative 0.5, which there is some pockets there, but this market is definitely more overbought than the previous three. So be aware of that. This market has way more room to the downside than the previous three. And so my point on that is, if you're going to look for buy triggers here, you better make it quick so you don't get ran over, just in case these small cap stocks finally start selling off. And then you go to the negative 1. It's not perfect, but a lot of that demand is going to be in the negative 1.5 and or the negative 2. And don't forget, we also have deviations on the three major Forex pairs. Just for tomorrow, we won't have deviations on gold futures. It did a rollover into the December contract. And so this is the December contract that will match up to NADEX indicative. And then we do have deviations in value area on crude oil futures. So make sure that you are taking pictures of all of your trades. Use the 4-step trading process. Post the bird's eye view. The worm's eye view, and the trade stamp in the BTG Trader Tribe, so that you can get feedback from me and from others.